Thank you, Duran. Thank you, everyone. And good evening and welcome to our second lecture in the archive series, second out of four lectures. As Doron said, my name is Matan Barzilai. I'm the head of the archives department in the National Library of Israel. And this time, we are pleased to host Guy Raz, who is here with us. Guy Raz is a photo curator of Eretz Israel Museum in Tel Aviv. I think I just met him, I think a few months ago, but I know that Guy Raz is living and breathing photographs for many, many years. And about 20 years ago in 2003, he edited the book called The Photographs of the Land, which reviews the photographers of Palestine and Israel, Eretz Israel and Israel, from the early days of the photography until today. In addition, he curated many photographs exhibitions in local galleries, as well as in well-known museums in Israel and abroad. One of those exhibitions in 2016 was about the retrospective of Aliza Orbach, whose personal estate was deposited in the National Library about 3 years ago in 2018. And I can say that in these very days, we are beginning to digitize and catalog the beautiful collection of Aliza Orbach photographs collection. And today's lecture, Guy Raz's lecture, will also refer to this, exactly to this beautiful collection of Aliza Orbach, and it is called Aliza Orbach Four Trilogies. So after this short prologue, Guy, the stage is yours, and we're all curious just to hear what you have to tell us.
Okay, hello everyone. My name is Guy Raz, as Matan said. Just before I start the presentation, just tell you that I'm in the middle of the mission. I'm dealing with the history of photography in Eretz Israel, Palestine since 1995. It was my first exhibition that I curated. And then I noticed that no one deals with the history of photography, with people research and dealing with the history of the state, but not the history of the photographers. So in 2000, I edited a kind of a magazine called Studio, and I put in the first page 120 names of, you know, photographers who died already. And then came to me from the Kibbutz HaMeuchad publishers and said, okay, let's add another 80 photographers that still alive, and we will make a book about 200 photographers between, let's say, 1855 till 2000. That's how come the book, The Photographer of the Land, that's published in 2003. Okay, so, but I'm, since then, you know, it's happened 20 years ago, I have in my my computer, my Excel, I have about almost 800 photographers, men and women. I research a very interesting section from photographers in the kibbutzim. Just there, I found around 300. Okay, almost every kibbutz got one or two photographers. So our lecture about Aliza Orbach, she's one of, you know, 800. So all the photographers, all the elders, all the died photographers are like, you know, my grandparents of the history of photography. And in the middle of the mission, and what, as Matan said, in 2016, about a year before, I met Aliza Orbach at her home and started to curate her exhibition. But unfortunately, she died about 3 or 4 months before the opening. But we worked very hard, so she knew almost where every picture will be on the wall. And she read my text for the catalog. So it was kind of one after, because, you know, it was a pity that she couldn't be there, but her soul, not in the images. She went also to me to the museum and, you know, look at the walls and understand where every image will be. So it was kind of a tragic project, but you know, she will be in the history, and I'm very happy that the library, the National Library, took her estate that you will see in a minute. Okay, so my lecture will give you a guide, first of all, to the women photographers in Israel, Palestine, and then we'll go into Eliza Orbach exhibition and project, okay? So I'm start with my presentation. You know what, before I start the presentation, I'll show you just a short video that you can just understand how she looked like and how she took images. It's in Hebrew, but just let's try to take a look. Okay. Can you see it, the video, before I'm starting?
Perfectly, thank you.
Okay.
תמונת ממלילה התחלתי לצלם לפני בערך כחצי שנה. זאת הייתה אולי פגישה מחודשת, כי בעבר, כשרק הגעתי לירושלים, צילמתי אותה לא ממש לעומק, אלא כמו שצילמתי שכונות אחרות. הפעם הגעתי לשכונה בעיקר בגלל שהיא הייתה בדרך לגן ביתי בימי משה. ואולי מה שתפס את העין שלי לראשונה, באופן בולט במיוחד, היה הקונטרסט הנורא בין שכונת ימין משה המפוארת ומשוחזרת לבין שכונת ממילה הגוססת. אני לא צלם.
אוקיי, just to see that you know, the person, how she took the photos, how she talked, you know, and then I'll go straight to the presentation. Okay, can you see it? Okay, so the image that I choose for the opening is image for one of her last project that she made in the National Library. It's called Widows. So the first image actually is almost the last image she took in her life. The lecture calls Eliza Orbach four trilogies. And that's when I work after her archive, I understand that she worked in a four theme, in a four ways. And that's how I also curated the exhibition. There was about four galleries, and every gallery was in one of the trilogies. Okay, the four trilogies was, let's say, the portrait of the people, motherhood, landscape, and words and letters. We can summer this exhibition, this lecture, and about just take a look of the cover of the book that Eliza Auerbach published in her life. She was one of the most active photographers and in Israel between 1970 till 2015, and she published more than 10, 12, maybe 15 books, and except maybe Peter Mirom that covered the Chula Lake and published book in the 60s, she's the most photographer that published a book in Israel. And we can summer this lecture in 5 images that I took from the, let's say, from the 4 trilogies. We can see a portrait of a people, we can see motherhood, we can see landscape, and we can see, it's not a letter, but it's, when I talk about photography, anyway, I say that every image is a letter, okay? And every 4 or 5 image is a sentence. And in the gallery, in the end of the exhibition, it's kind of lyric. So for me, every click on the camera, every image is a letter that start to write the language of photography. Okay, so we can summer Aliza Orbach legacy through these 5 images. Wait a second. Okay, the exhibition and the book, it was a retrospective in a way, it summer all her legacy. And when we talk about portrait of people, we talk about the project of the pioneers in 1990, the Aliyah, the immigration 1992, and survivors of the Holocaust in 2009. When I talk about motherhood, we talk about the mother of the earth, woman at work, and Glenna, she's the mother of Aliza Orbach. She also one of her last project, she came back to her mother. Landscape, she deal with elegy ruins in Israel, also the sea, and in the end, kind of again, elegy of Israel, as she saw from her point of view. The letters start almost in the last 5 years when she lived, and she coming back to write stories. Okay, and the stories was with images. She also coming back to Haifa where she born. Then she made the project of the reader in the National Library at in the end 2016, the exhibition called Life. Okay, now it's okay, it's stuck. Okay. When I also deal with the whole history of photography in Israel, on the right, you can see the cover of the Photographer of the Land, 2003. In the middle, it's a cover of a book that didn't publish yet. It's the history of a photographer in the kibbutzim. And on the left, another idea of a book of the women photographers in Eretz Israel, Palestine. It's a kind of, you know, files on my computer, and I hope that one day this other 2 books will show, and you know, I can do my trilogy about the history of photographers in Israel. When I came to talk about the women photographers in Palestine, Eretz Israel, we have to know to understand that the legacy of photography in Israel or Eretz Israel till 1948 was just by men. There is I found women photographers in archives, other places, but what you can find in the Zionist archive and the JNF archives are just men. Okay, so if you want to find women photographer, you have to go to the families, okay? Or even if they're staying in the Zionist archive, no one touched them. So they are a long or very big mission just to write the history of women photographers in Eretz Israel, Palestine. And what can I tell you from, let's say, 5 or 6 exhibitions that I made for women photographer that maybe we will not write again the history of the country, but we can we will see, let's say, the history of day of life, okay? The history of not wars, not pioneers, not all the other, you know, images that the Zionist movement asked for the men photographers. And the women photographer, actually most of them in the beginning was studio. They work in the studio because they cannot go outside with, you know, big cameras to the fields. But when we will continue till, let's say, 1970, when women start to do art like men photographers, they are part of the history of photography, like men, when the photography start to be an art section. Okay, but till 1970, there were almost no one know about women photographers. And I made in 2019 an exhibition that show a women photographer from the 19th century till 1978. And I found around 106 women photographers. So this is the beginning of the book of the history. And most of them are just in my computer. Okay, no one heard about them, most of them. In between 1933 to 1948, there were two centers of photography in Eretz Israel, Palestine. One of them around the photographer Helmer Lersky in Tel Aviv, and the other one was Alfred Bernheim in Jerusalem. There was no almost a school or art school in Eretz Israel that, you know, teaching photography, except Bezalel for some years. So Lersky and Bernheim was, let's say, you know, the old photographer that most of the photographers came to talk to them and study from them. And there was this center was in Tel Aviv and Jerusalem. There were also couples that work together, men and women, wife and husband that work together. There was also partners, women that work together in the same studio. There was photographer who study in art academy in most of them in Europe before they came to Israel. So they have, you know, the tradition of photography in Europe from Vienna or from Berlin. Some of them began their career in the kibbutzim. That's what I found. And it's very interesting. You will see in a minute some images of them. And other women photographer was assistant of men photographers. Okay, so that's how the history of women photographers start in Israel. So now we go into Eliza Auerbach home and archive. What do you see on the left? It's what is in the National Library now. When I met Eliza Auerbach first time, I just went to her home and she was very like Yeke, you know, she was very, worked very, how do you say, Mesudar. And you can find every negative in every place that you want. But so you can see how it looked like in the beginning. On the right, on the bottom, you can see images of Eliza Auerbach as a child. That's what how what I found in you know, in the albums. And these images took by very important photographer in Haifa. She born in Haifa, and so Eliza Auerbach is part of the history of photography by images that took by Julian First, photographer in Haifa in 1942-1943. Two images by Eliza Auerbach, as you saw before on the video, but just how she looked like and how she holds the camera, you know, how she walked and took all images that we will see in a minute. On the right, you can see, you know, kind of self-portrait against the mirror. And on the left, how she looked like, you know, a year or two before she died. Okay, so it's another history. Actually, like, you know, she take self-portrait of herself in that slide. On the left, you can see the enlarger of Aliza Orbach before she moved from analog photography to the digital. And it stay, I don't know if it came to the National Library, but it's part of her archive.
I don't think I saw that.
What?
I don't think I saw this one. So okay. I'm not sure it's yeah. In our place.
Okay, on the right and on the left, you can see Aliza Orbach letters or texts. When we walk about the exhibition, you can see it's above, it's written a photo for the book. And on the left, there is the list of the survivors' images that she took and she won that will be in the exhibition. So you can see how we work together, okay? So every day that I came to her before she died, it was, you know, like we have to be in rush and we work very hard. And I was very, it was very important to me to finish the work before she died. Actually, you can see her, her home again with two chairs, you know, one of mine and one of her. And, you know, you can see the floor that her husband, Gideon Ofrat, still live in this house, okay? These are the video that we saw in the beginning. And what I say also, it's one of the influence of the Israeli photography, and but especially of Aliza Orbach, was that exhibition, The Family of Men, that you can see images on the left from that book. And here you can see image by Eugene Smith on the right. And on the left, you can see image by Aliza Orbach, okay? So when she started to do photography, she was influenced by this book, The Family of Men. And she actually made The Family of Men of Israel, okay? Most of her images from the 70s and the 80s, she took images of people. She started in Jerusalem, and also she took images also in the United States, you will see in a minute. But if I came back again to the history of women photography, you can see that image by Aliza Orbach from 1972. It's actually where the painter, or also where Aliza standing is where Israel Museum now, okay? And on the back, there is Israel Museum, and here you can see Jerusalem from the point of view of Israel Museum. But what I want to show you is image from 1940 that took by Lou Landauer. She was a woman photographer. And this image you can see from the roof of Bezalel. Okay, she teaches photography in Bezalel, and for about 3 or 4 years between 1940 till 1944. But in the future exhibition, I can put these two images next to each other. Okay, a woman photographer took image of painter in Jerusalem. What happened in 2016, when we made the exhibition of Aliza Orbach, it was in En Harod, in the Mishkan L'Omanut, in the big museum of art in En Harod. But there was a small museum in the same kibbutz in En Harod called Sturman House, Beit Sturman. And I exhibited two exhibitions at the same time on the right. One of the first woman photographer in the kibbutz in En Harod, her name was Tzipora David, and on the left you can see image by Aliza Orbach. So, in the same time that I made Aliza Orbach, I also, you know, the people that came to En Harod can see in a way the history of women photographer through two exhibitions. Okay, Tzipora David, that document En Harod, the pioneers in the 1923, and Aliza Orbach in the 70s all over the world. Some images before the trilogies, there was, as I told you, she took images also from 70, she was in the United States on the up on the left, but she started to document children's, and also she documented theaters in the Khan Theater in Jerusalem. And on the right, up on the right, you can see the bells of Imka, house in Jerusalem. And in the middle, down in the middle, you can see, you know, soldier that, you know, just walk on the street in Jerusalem. So, but you can see the beginning, the very early images by Eliza Auerbach before she decided to do art or to do a conceptual project. Okay, on the right, image from United States, from, I guess, New Orleans. And on the left, a family photo from Israel from almost the same years. Okay, so we can see how her language of photography start to develop. She, in the 17th, she almost, most of her work was for newspapers, okay? So she document, you know, famous people for the newspaper. On the right, the big image, the woman is Anna Tichow, okay? And on the left, you can see Samach Yizhar and Yeshayahu Leibovich and Chaim Guri, okay? People like that, that, you know, the newspaper sent her to, just took images, okay? But she also took special images from, you know, from the legacy of Jerusalem. On the right, you can see Rabbi Tzvi Yehuda Kook, okay? And on the left, there was Selma Meyer, Schwester Selma, she was a nurse in Shaare Tzedek Hospital. In these two images, she started to concentrate. She, you can see how she controlled the light, okay? The develop of controlling the light. And then we start, you know, the first trilogy, Portrait of a People. The first project was 1990, called Pioneers. And she understand that these people that, you know, establish Israel or Eretz Israel, you know, will gone in a few years. So she took her car from Jerusalem all the way to Dgania and Jezreel Valley and start to document pioneers. Okay, on the left, you can see Eliyahu Amitzur from Kfar Yehoshua, that born in 1903 in Galicia. And on the right, you can see Frida Atiya, that she came from Morocco, and you know, was part of Kfar Tavor members. Okay, but you can see how she took all her knowledge from photography and put it on one project, the Pioneers. Okay, we can see Eliyahu Amitzur on the left, but we can see image by a woman photographer from Mishmar HaEmek from the 1920 that, you know, you can, I also can put that image against to Eliza Auerbach. It's almost the same person, but took 70 years early by woman photographer in Mishmar HaEmek. Okay, her name was Rachel Ron. And of course, we can see the influence of the photographer August Sander of Eliza Auerbach when she took, you know, this project of the pioneers. Two years later, she understand that she want, you know, to deal with the history of the country. And there was a big Aliyah in 1992, also from Soviet Union and from Ethiopia. So she, you know, talked who she need to talk and took the flight also to Soviet Union, to Leningrad and other places, and also to Ethiopia, and make one of the first project of our time of immigration after, you know, the big immigration in 1948-1949 after the Holocaust and also from Yemen. Okay, but and no one sent her. If we talk about the immigration, this project was not sponsored by JNF or other. She do it from her own passion. Okay, so it's the second section of the portrait of the people. So here we can see another, you know, junction, you know, the Alexandra Bilinski that came from Leningrad, and Ksam Banesh Aimzek that came from Ethiopia. Two women, you know, on the left, she's old woman, but on the right, young girl from Russia. But in two images, you can see, you know, the history of the immigration from the 1992 in Israel. We can also talk about, you know, the composition of the frame, the hands that, you know, that cut the frame in the middle, the look of the eyes. The Russian girl looks straight to the eyes, the Ethiopian don't look to the camera, okay? But we can talk about Eliza Auerbach's point of view. This how, you know, these two people find themselves in the Ben Gurion airport in the same time. Okay, on the right you have the immigration, the immigrants from Russia, and on the left from Ethiopia. The section of this trilogy is The Survivors that she made in 2009. And also, you know, it's almost like to do the pioneer. She understands that if she will not cover the survivors of the Holocaust, they will vanish, you know, they will have no kind of documentation. So like in the pioneers, she start to looking for survivors all over the state. And what is important, like in the pioneers, it's the caption, not just to take the image, but who is that person, who is this man, who is that woman, from where, from which ghetto they survived. Okay, that's for example Sarah Rubin, that lived in Bnei Brak. She was in Auschwitz and Theresienstadt, okay? And Yossi Weiss from Zichron Yaakov was in Novaki forced labor camp, okay? So also the story by few words, where they came from, okay, and where they born. You can see also the how close she was to the people that she took their images. She was very close to them physically. Okay, it's not like you know, the JNF photographer that, you know, took it from distance. She talked to them, she came to them, and they understand that she make, you know, the documentation for forever. And also when we come back to the history of photography, we can see other woman photographer. Her name is Vardi Kahana. Okay, that she document her mother and her two, the three sisters, that one of them is her, she's her mother. You can see the number one, you know, next to each other, that three sisters came out from Auschwitz, okay? But as a curator, I can also start to think about the survivor or the Holocaust exhibition in contemporary photography in Israel. The second trilogy is about motherhood, okay? She document mothers and women all over the world. I just put that image on the left that you can see also the influence, you know, you can see the hand of the mother or the grandmother hold the baby, but also on the bottom, the hand of the Holocaust survivor. Okay, the hands. So hands is also another point of view by Eliza Orbach. In 1997, I don't know where from, but I think from Germany, a publisher sent her to document mother all over the globe. Okay, and it was published in a book in Germany. Okay, so you can see, I guess, from Thailand in a way, or from Africa, she traveled the world by this project of Mother of Earth. At the same time, when I curated the exhibition, we understand that we can do it in two sections, but she document most of the images at the same time. Okay, woman at work and mother on earth. The years that you can see on the slide, it was when the exhibition or the book published, but the images are from the same time, from 1997, 1998. Here we can see the family of men, okay? Influence. We can, these images could be in that project. And the last image in that section is it's called Lene, and she came back to her mother before her mother died, okay? She came to, when we talk about a woman at work and mother of earth, she came back to her mother. Okay, she document the fragments of her mother before she died, before the mother died. And she put that images against abstract landscape of Israel. Okay, that's actually this, we will see in a minute the exhibition, but these four images were the opening of Eliza Orbach exhibition. The abstract and the mother. The land and the mother. The next trilogy is the landscape that she covered the state of Israel, and there is it's kind of, you can see we are on 2002, 2007, some project without people, okay, just abstract, just landscape. Okay, this image is 5 minutes from her home in Jerusalem. And you can see the palms, trees, there are several units like that in Israel that you can see, but on the right and on the left, when she came close to the tree, it's like a portrait, okay? When she documented trees from close, you can see it, you can imagine the portrait of a man, okay? And again, in the exhibition, I could put the image of the landscape from 2002 again against the image of the pioneers from 1990, okay? It's Jezreel Valley. On the right, it's the Mount Gilboa behind the women. And on the left, it's a point of view to the other side, to what we call Givat HaMoreh, okay? But the composition of the image, it's almost the same. And in 2007, she moved straight to abstract. She went to the Sea of Tel Aviv and just document, you know, fragments of the sea. She called it the Song of the Sea. Again, landscape, the song of, like we see here, the Song of the Sea, it's a song of the land, you know, kind, she was very, I can say she was very unsatisfied from, you know, where Israel is going politically and mentally. She saw from her window the Har HaBayit, okay? She lived in Abu Tor in Jerusalem. And everything that happened, you know, was came, she can see the sound of the violence from her window, and she was very unsatisfied, and she documented in a way in black and white the fragment of the state of Israel. When we go to the last trilogy, I call it Letters, because she, you can see 2011, 2013, she published two books, two exhibitions. The first one is the exquisite taste of Shigorinsky figs. It's the Shigorinsky was her neighbor in Haifa where she born. So she came back to Haifa and document images from the street where she lived, and also write text about her memories from that place. So it was a small book that called the exquisite taste of Shigorinsky figs. And 2013, she made the project of the National Library just document readers in, and also workers in the National Library. That exhibition was in the National Library Gallery. I don't know if Matan remember that, but it was there.
Of course, I remember that. And also today it's on the walls of the corridors of the National Library until today.
Okay. And this is the cover of the book of the retrospective. And the name of the book, of the exhibition, Life, it was very emotional name because, and Gideon Ofrat, her husband, decided that this will be the name because, you know, she died half a year before. And what you can see in the book is the life that she documented, but also the life of Aliza Auerbach. So that's what we called it, Life. And this, and the first, you know, when you open the book, the first image is, I decide it will be a woman, and we saw it before, it's Frida Atiyah from the Pioneers Project. Because I was involved in the family, of course, you can see images from the funeral in 2016. And on the left, you can see the grave a month after, okay, by Aliza Auerbach. With the person with the hat is Gideon Ofrat, her husband. And here with the green and yellow trousers is her daughter, Eden. She's an artist too, okay? So I just, you know, document the funeral. I take you for a minute to the exhibition just to see how it looked like in Enharod. You can imagine, you know, climbing the stairs and take a look of the portrait. Okay, on the right you can see her mother. Also on the right and on the left, the opening text. The portrait, and then go into the four trilogies that we talked already. Okay? This is in En Harod, 2016. We also made a kind of memorial conference that called Photography and Humanism for her memory. And it was also very important to me, you know, not just, you know, to show the images, but also to talk. Some articles in the newspaper about Eliza Auerbach. You can see some of these images. And my last mission was to show part of that exhibition from En Harod in Jerusalem, okay, to bring her back home in a way. And so we made that exhibition in Artist House in Jerusalem a year later. And we called it Not Life, we called it From Stone to the Sea. Stone represents Jerusalem, and sea represents Haifa, where she born. Okay, so that exhibition was with less images, but you know, I want that Eliza Auerbach will exhibit in Jerusalem. So you can see the poster from outside, you can see the stones of Jerusalem, of the artist house on the left, and her portrait with the camera, you know, almost alive in Jerusalem. Another text in the newspaper, also in English, in Jerusalem Post. And I'm finished this short lecture with the stamp of Eliza Auerbach as a photographer. When I go to archive, the first thing that I'm doing after I watch the image, I turn it upside down and take a look, who is the photographer? And if he's a professional one that, you know, arranged to himself a stamp. Otherwise, he's not a professional, maybe. So these are the stamp of Eliza Auerbach as a woman photographer in Israel from 1972 or 3 till 2016. So this is my lecture for today. I think, I hope you enjoy. And if you have a question, that's the time.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ruz. That was wonderful, and there are compliments in the chat. Where was her work shown?
What?
Where was her work shown? Where? Exhibition.
Yeah, I called in En Harod, in the House of Art and Mishkan L'Omanut in En Harod, and also in the artist house in Jerusalem. And you know, all the images are belong now to the National Library, so actually we can re-exhibit it, but you know, it takes time and someone wants to see it. I tried to move it to abroad, but I didn't succeed yet. But it could be also, if someone have an idea, and after the corona maybe, or not, or during the corona, I'm used to do that, you know, to take an exhibition that I made in Israel abroad. For example, I made in 2019 exhibition about the first prima ballerina, 1925 in Eretz Israel. Her name was Rina Nikova, and it was exhibited in Jerusalem. And a year after, I exhibited in Bialystok in Poland, where she born. Okay, so it's very, because it's photography, it's very flexible. We can reprint almost everything or just keep it.
Thank you very much.
May I say, Doron, that it was really interesting, fascinating, and I saw some things that I don't think they reached the National Library Archives. And I think we will do some completion in Gideon Ofrat House. It gives us a lot of passion and motivation to do this, to deal with this beautiful photograph selection, which we just began, as I said before, we just began in these very days. And we hope to complete approximately in by the end of this year, and there's already a great interest, some of it from Beit Avichai in Jerusalem, that want to also to exhibit some of those pictures. Maybe they've been in touch with you, and we're cooperating with everyone in Israel, abroad, everywhere. So thank you very much, Guy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. In your opinion, what makes her work stand out in comparison to other Israeli photographers of her time?
I think she was very, she worked actually by, she was not part of the clique, you know, she had no group. She had no, almost, she was worked very solitude. And that's why I think she was not, you know, part of the scene of Israeli photography art. She was no friend, okay? But she was very concentrated in her work. And I think, you know, to compare to other photographer from her time, she was one of the greats.
Thank you very much. She shared her life with Dr. Gidon Ofrat, who was an art critic. Mm-hmm. Do you know how that, if that, and if so, how did it affect her work? And did they work together?
And I, when I curated this exhibition, I visited their home. I ate lunch with them, with both of them. And from what I know, they decide or they didn't want to involve each one in the other project. Okay, so Aliza was a photographer and Gidon was a critique of art. And I don't know if it's also part of the issue that, you know, didn't want to show her because she's the wife of Gidon Ofrat, but in the house, there was no, they tried to work everyone in his profession.
Thank you very much. Sarah asks, where did she study photography?
Actually, she was autodidact. She didn't study in kind of academy. It's very unique to that time of the in the Israeli photography. She started in the late 60s. There was no school of art anyway. The school of art and photography section start in the end of the 70s in Israel. Okay, you know, the second leg after Bezalel in the 40s, the Department of Photography in School of Art in Israel starting the end of 70s, beginning of 80s. So she was autodidact.
Thank you very much. Both you and Matan mentioned that her archive is in the National Library of Israel. Do we know subsequently what her inspiration was?
What is inspiration?
Well, what were the sources of her inspiration? Where did she get the drive to photograph such portraits all over the world?
Actually, I guess I show some images in the exhibition, in the presentation. You know, Family of Men, she mentioned, you know, as kind of, the exhibition was in Israel in the 50s. Okay, so as a child, she went to see it. Okay, she watched it. So it was kind of influence. And, but actually she started, she was a teacher of teaching Bible before she started her career as a photographer, but from the Bible to document the country, it's not a long distance. And she moved in the beginning from the letters, from the Holy, you know, book to the Holy Land. That's in a way kind of move that she made as a photographer.
Thank you very, very much, Guy Raz. Thank you, Matan, Barzilai. Thank you all for being here. I'm going to turn the microphones on. So if anyone has any more questions or just wants to say thank you, you're more than welcome. And have a good night. We'll see you at our next event.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And Laila Tov from Jerusalem.
Yeah. Okay. Bye-bye. Thank you.